as I always like to say, it's time to bring out the big guns. Let's play CSGO by Valve Corporations.
This is the map, Vito, and now let's see what do they choose. And it's gonna be Inferno!
A knife round, everybody has a little sense of decorum. Like, gentlemen, they march down the mid lane. It seems like the CTs are winning. I have to ask you, Jireen, in your opinion, if you were marksman after winning the knife round, what side would you choose?
CT, because it's definitely a CT side map.
Okay.
And they have stay.
Okay.
It's actually a city-sided map, and everyone mostly chooses city-side because at the start they just have to play a little defensive, and after a while when the first half that happens, and then they can switch. So it's a little bit easier to come on from the T-side.
Okay.
Comparatively, when you are playing city, you have to go for a good score.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I've been noticing this even at other tournaments. Whoever gets the start on the CT side usually tends to do well and probably take the map. Let's see if Marksmen can get that going for them. And in the mid lane, of course, the range with the USPs is going to work. They wouldn't want to give away any early kills. This is a bit risky by Sloane. He could get punished. He's given away his position. But he gets a one tap onto SMX. Sloane working with the man advantage.
Well, how's Annie is in? He's in the trap of Rich and Paul tag teaming him up. And two players have already been down from the T side, but Batman comes in with two frags. He is playing amazing. It's a 3v2 situation. The players are a little bit split, but they may. Oh, but Veerbhadra takes a shot on Batman. The C4 has gone on cover alone, left in this situation. It's Tags. Tags Paul and Bomb goes down, but Veerbhadra coming in with a headshot. Kappa goes down. The first round has been gone to the marksman.
Beautifully done by Veerbhadra there. That one tap. Near house and managing to secure the trade for the debt on his fellow teammate. Marksmen getting the win, getting that early money. A couple of CZs, upgraded pistols, and a little bit of Kevlar and helmets coming out. Mithil holding to the bomb. Banana control is so crucial in this map, and I like what the CTs are doing. Marksmen immediately throwing down the Molotov. That's going to buy them at least 7 seconds of time. I presume the Akramaks are going to play this slow and just wait for the smokes to dissipate, wait for the Molotovs to clear, and then possibly make their move. It's also really crucial that nobody from the side of Marksmen overpeaks and gives away a kill, because if Akramaks are working with a man advantage, it could mean that they could do some economic damage by maybe just getting the bomb planted, which is really crucial in an eco round. And that's going to be the primary target for the Akramaks here, I presume.
Both teams are really passive right now. There's no, a lot of movement from both the teams. They're just, blocking them with, smokes.
Yeah.
And but they don't want them to give, an entry point. So they don't want to risk it at this early stage because they still have, 50 seconds. So they can do a lot more. The C4 just needs 4 seconds to plant at the end crucial moment. It can be planted. It's not a huge risk. But yeah, looking at these aggressive play, but Paul is ready. The shot will go with. Well, he's missing few shots, but the players are already there. Sloane taking down two players.
Riggs and Sloane watching house. Riggs gets one on the SMX. Now they managed to retrieve a little bit. Mithil in a man fight, can't take down Venom. Marksmen win the round and they're going into round three with a lot of money to work with. I'm really curious to see if Akramaks do commit to upgrading the Kevlar here. They're going to pick up a little bit of utility. Mithil goes for the frag grenade.
That would be just a single buy coming in from Mithil just for frag grenade. But they should not buy in this situation because if they lose this one as well, they won't have any buy for the third round as well. That would be an issue for them. The economy has been already short. And they're just rushing at Ali. And
Veerbhadra is waiting. The Molotov is there. How do you push? A smoke? Dispates the Molotov. Waiting. Batman will fall. Venom and Veerbhadra teaming up together. They will not let Akramaks enter Banana. And they'll even bring down SMX. Marksmen get up to a convincing start with their first three rounds, and Akramaks, well, it's time for them to buy. Let's see if they can find some form of recovery here.
Venom, it was his ace for him, and he was very aggressive on their face. At the last frag, he just went with the pistol. He just wants those frags, he wants it.
Yeah, good stuff coming up from the Batman. He's bought an auto sniper, if I'm not mistaken. I presume he's going to be looking to peek mid and maybe try and punish anyone who goes for early pushes. You got the AWP on Veerbhadra. He's got to be careful with it. And he's more than careful. He brings down Manan. Good stuff coming out from Veerbhadra there. And with the smoke covering Banana, Akramaks, I mean, they're going to spend the next couple of minutes or the next 30 seconds or so hanging around mid and alt mid, hoping that Marksmen push and give away the advantage, which is the last thing Marksmen want to do.
Currently, the T's are just waiting for the game read. Like, they want to just understand what are the CT's poses and where can we enter, where there's, like, less to engage with someone.
Right.
And if they get a hold and pick, so they would go for that gameplay.
But okay. Currently,
yeah, look, they're actually smoking off, like, all nooks and corners, so they can move easily. But this can be a fake, but... No, they have already made an entry to the bomb site.
Read this quite well. He's rotated to the bomb set as well. Riggs gets one. Kappa manages to bring down Pawn and he's bought down Riggs. The AWP making the rotation only to find the rest of his team nearly wiped out. It's a 3-on-2 situation. Slowin is trying to attempt a retake here. Maybe with Veerbhadra coming into the AWP, they could possibly find someone woefully out of position. Slowin approaching through house. Veerbhadra just managed to bring down SMX. He's pushing mid to right. He's near the bomb site. Slowin's got Veerbhadra. It's a 1-on-2. Kappa.
Oh my God.
Well, he gets Veerbhadra, but Slowin and Riggs team up and get the return frag. Another win for Marksmen. And they're off to a good start so far on the CT side. You did mention during the knife round that everybody wants CT. And the Marksmen are making the most of it so far.
The economy, they still, they did get the bomb plant, so they can go for a buy, but there would be like a cheap buy. They won't be able to buy the resources on the T side. They won't be able to buy any resources or utilities. You just smoke off or do anything much. Like to enter a bomb site, they will have to like block vision there. Only Kappa has like two flashes, a smoke and a molly to work with. Mm-hmm. Other teammates have nothing. So it's mainly on Kappa who decides like when to push. So his utilities are very important for this round.
So I'm honestly a bit disappointed with how the Akramaks are approaching Banana. You see a molly, throw a smoke on it. You smoked yourself, but then throw a flash and push. But Rex, he's not even letting them approach house. He's bought down SMX. Mithil will get the kill on Veerbhadra. And this might open up Banana for them. It's Venom versus the Resh. Any rotations just yet from Marksmen? Seems like there aren't. Venom slowly pushing towards the fountain. He's got Kevlar and helmet, but he's all by himself. Akramaks, they're shit scared to enter Banana. They're being patient. And this patience might hurt them because this is an opportunity for Marksmen to rotate and hold Banana. Venom with the spray. He gets Batman. Kappa to the bomb side. He pushes and he gets Venom right between the eyes. They're pretty much cleared this bomb side. They've got Pawn as well. It's a 2v2. Can Mithil and Manan, the good old lords of CS 1.6, win the round for Akramaks?
Let's see. Does the magician be able to pull the rabbit out of his hat?
Yeah.
It's a 2v2 situation. Both the players are playing slow. They just wanted to get the info. But Manan picks on Slowin with a nice headshot. And Riggs has already pulled down Mithil over here.
Riggs does have a defusal kit, so he can play this slow. But he
Manan
throws out the flash.
Low on HP, man. Manan, oh, this is really crucial, Manan. You have to win this. You're just on like 6. A tap of a breath. But Manan gets Riggs with a headshot. He was so low on HP, man.
Good stuff coming up from Akramaks. Manan being so patient, didn't peek unnecessarily, held his calm, waited in what, for all purposes, is the clutch, and secured it with a sweet headshot. Good stuff coming up from Akramaks. And as you can see, we do have a Famous and submachine gun coming out from Venom. So they're a little hurt in terms of utility. And Venom's still gone for the molly, so that's going to help with that Banana control that Marksmen have been trying time and time again. A lot of mollies and smokes being thrown out. There's a smoke to dissipate the molly. But, I mean, Akramaks have to wait a good 17 seconds if they want to push until the smoke dissipates.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it's... Riggs manages to bring down Batman.
Well, there's always something happening. Like, just one guy from the T side is pushing somewhere and, like, the players are already ready for that push. Like, the CTs are already ready for a push.
Yeah.
So that's actually like there's something, a stat has to be changed from the Akramaks side because they don't have to like play a lot separate game like the players. Even look now, like the player, like he's just falling back. Mithil is way away because Mithil's actual role in the like in this CS game is he has already been the entry fagger for a lot of teams.
Okay.
Like early when he was playing for other teams, like he used to play as the entry fagger. Currently, I don't know why they have put up to that.
But the bees have already made an entry to the bomb site. Bees are dropping two down and Venom with one more kill on the bottom. But Mithil, the lone guy left over here, he has to pull this clutch for his team. But he is currently falling back, like thinking like the rotation would have come from behind and catches Rix off guard. Oh my god, and like he is just falling back and Slowin to the rescue at bomb site A. He is actually rotated perfectly at the perfect time for bomb site A, but Mithil is just gonna go and plant that bomb.
So, I mean, it's a 2v1. Slowin does have a diffuse kit. Mithil, he's moving towards house eventually. Slowin and Pa, how do they do this? I mean, Manan did manage to win a clutch in the earlier round. Can Mithil do it this time around? He's got Kevlar and helmets, so he's got some form of sustain. The CTs, they don't know where Mithil is. They move towards balcony. They're waiting. Mithil goes in, gets the headshot. It's a 1v1 and a pawn under pressure. Pawn wants to peek, pawn wants to bring it down and then go for the defuse.
And Mithil punished. Oh my god, this guy is insane. He is crazy. Pulls out a clutch. That's an ace. 1v5.
Yeah, beautiful stuff coming out from Mithil and Akramaks. They're clawing their way back into this game. And look at the money. The marksmen are poor. They've gone for a couple of pistols, a couple of CZs. This looks worse than my own bank balance. And how do marksmen find a way back? They have to win this eco. I'm not sure what the strat is for the eco. Pawn already gives it away that he's a bit poor by firing a couple of shots in the mid lane. There's no utility on the CT side and SMX will punish them. He gets risk. Mithil, I mean, it's like the last round never ended. He's still hitting headshot after headshot. He brings down Slowin and the Akramaks, they're 5v3. They should ideally win this. I mean, they're not even finding trades on the side of the Marks. Pawn knows that they're pushing mid to left, wants to peek, but Manan ready, gets the kill and Akramaks win the round.
Mithil is just going crazy. He has got three frags now again in this round. He has got that momentum now.
Yeah.
So it would be hard, like they have to shut him down, otherwise if he gets that like confident,
yeah,
it would be very like hard for marksmen to come back in the game.
I mean, CS is so momentum driven. You heard this time and time again, arey yaar, mere shots nahi lag rahe. And when your shots hit, it's a good feeling. Mithil, he's riding on that. And hopefully, Akramaks could manage to bring out a reasonable score on the T side here. What I'm a little disappointed with is how when they enter Banana, there's a lack of smokes and flash coming out from the terrace side. They're not flashing the site very effectively. They're not doing a very planned entry. Their T side leaves a lot to be desired. And when he manages to find a pickoff, Kappa does retrieve the bomb, however. So Akramaks are working with something. But yeah, I mean, every time you look at Akramaks go to Banana, there's no flash to enter the site. It seems as if they don't know the flashes that they need to use to enter the site itself. I'm not even seeing the CT side being smoked. It's a little disappointing. They're relying too much on aim. And versus better teams, this could punish them.
But CT's with a one-man advantage still, like, I think they would be... Yes, it's a fake on bomb side A and they are now actually moving towards bomb side B. The same alley thing. Let's see. Will they be like putting up any smokes or mollies to just enter?
So Kappa is holding on to
they don't have any flashbangs. They just have
Kappa
like
has one.
Yeah, Kappa only has one.
And Mithil has a smoke, if I'm not mistaken. Kappa throws out the flash. There's the smoke. But Veerbhadra is on the CT stack, so you should be able to see about that. And they don't bother to check. Veerbhadra gets one, jumps off. And once again, marksman working with a man advantage. Slowin walking through the smoke and falling back as well. He wanted to peek, but that smoke is going to ensure that Slowin got... Oh! That hurt. I don't think Slowin even knows what he did there.
He's trying for the spam, but Kappa has already moved back. Like they are just like holding like a passive posies now. That's actually good. But Mithil can be catched off guard over here because he can be like he can get back like fired like from both the sides if he is trapped. Badman taking one frag and Mithil gets one as well. Rix pulls out Mithil, but Badman with one more frag. It's a 2v2 situation. Both the players are with like proper rifles. Then Kappa is low on HP and Rix kills the last man, Kappa. And now defusing the bomb, they take a 2-round lead. It's 5-3 the scoreline. Marksman with the lead.
Beautiful stuff coming out from Marksman. That was a really well done retake. And Veerbhadra, I mean, it was their round to lose because they were working with a 2-man advantage, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
But retakes are hard, and there was a good amount of synergy there on display from the side of Marksman. 5-3 is the score. The Akramaks are still working with a bit of money. they can still buy, primarily because they did get the plant off, and you obviously get a little bit of gold for losing the round. 5-3, I mean, it's still not clear who's taking this away. We don't have a clear winner just yet.
But they do have resources to work with now. This round can go on Akramaks side. They do have resources that they can work with. And on the CT side, like, they are every time on CT side, everyone has to play passive. It's not a necessary point to just go aggressive and play. They now have got a call from Ali, and the CTs have already been very much aggressive, and they have already taken over bomb site A, and the CTs are just holding here. Looks like they are gonna save, and they are not going for it. They don't want to take a 5v3 fight. Instead, they'll go and save their armors. That's very important.
I agree. Looks like a save, and I don't blame them. It's gonna help. I presume Rix and Pawn are not doing too well in terms of money. And Marksmen, they'll probably go for a save, maybe get a couple of entry frags, an AK or two, and a couple of exit frags. An AK or two would be nice. And Akramaks are gonna win this round.
Even the T's won't actually go and hunt for them.
It's not worth hunting.
I don't think so, because even they are like not good with the economy currently. Mm-hmm. Because if their guns go down, see, look at...
Yeah.
Look at Veerbhadra, he has like two guys coming in, like, and they both are on low HP. They are still hunting for him. Like, if one goes down, second goes down,
the third
and going for the AK.
but that was some serious economic damage. I'm not sure Akramaks needed to peek. The good news is Mithilf has money, so he could drop an AK if he needs to.
That could have been a save properly.
That could have been a save. That was unnecessary. That was ill-disciplined of them, and they really didn't need to go. Or maybe they should have peeked a bit smarter. They went one by one. Veerbhadra sprayed them one after another and took away their guns. Once again, the CT stack taking place on the A bomb side. But the Akramaks, they have been preferring B a fair bit.
Well, Mithil is just going slowly, checking all nooks and corners, but Veerbhadra already... This is actually a common posey. Previous game, what I saw was that Kappa and Mithil did a very funny thing. What happened is, Kappa just came over here, he stacked Mithil, and he just smokes off the passage over there.
Okay.
So he gave a fake fire and went to the side, and the players thought like, okay, the fire is actually coming from the side, so the players are there. And they moved towards side, and Mithil got the frags from behind. That was like a bait.
Veerbhadra is getting this again. I mean, this is silly. Akramaks, come on. It's not too uncommon a position. You got to check. That smoke is not a wall that stops bullets. And Mananda, you can't stop him when he's in form. He manages to bring down Venom. And it's a 4-on-4. A couple of SMG and a pharmacy on the side of Marksman. Manan, he's going ham. He gets Veerbhadra. It's a 4v3 Marksman. I presume a rifle upgrade for Pawn would be nice. A save?
Yeah, they're again going for a save. They do have only SMGs, but the important thing is they have to save their armor, because they can at least hold from a grenade.
Mm-hmm. Save the armor by some utility. Is that what you're saying? Buy a couple of flashes, smokes.
Because you don't want to waste a huge amount on armor. If it's like a little bit damaged, like till it's 60, like, you can still manage.
Right.
If it goes on, you'll have to spend again $1,000 on an armor. That's waste.
Okay. But yeah, what's waste is Akramaks going and dying like that. I mean, sure, they won the round, but once again, you got a couple of upgrades. If I'm not mistaken, Sloan was sitting with an SMG. Now he has an AK. He can drop for his fellow teammates as well. But Marksmen, they're truly hurt in terms of economy. It's a hard round for them. I mean, if they lose this, they're only going to get poorer and poorer. Yeah. On the side of the Akramaks, they're doing too bad. Kappa has a little bit of money. SMX does as well. This round is going to be crucial, and it's probably going to dictate the tempo for the rest of the game as well.
If you look at the gameplay, they're just like mauling off this location. That's where they don't want the Akramaks to enter. And they're also smoking off the T entrance.
Yeah.
So it's not like they don't have much space to move. Like, it's like a trap. If there's a smoke over here and over here, so you're just trapped in between, and there's nothing much to do. So, they have currently made a decision. They have moved to bombsite A.
But it's something that can be dealt with. I mean, if you throw a molly, if you throw a smoke on their molly, and then throw a flash into your smoke, When you throw a flash into smoke, nobody sees the flash coming.
Yeah.
And the opponents get flashed and you enter. But that requires coordination. And in Indian CS, we like aim more than coordination.
That's true. And he is burning. Ah. Oh my god. That was a roast for him, but still a 5-5 situation. But Riggs picks up Manan, bad man taking the exit back over there. Mithil picks up Riggs, low in with two frags coming in, but goes down by SMX, giving him a headshot. It's a 2v2 situation. The two players are on a SMG. Venom is on SMG and Veerbhadra with a Farmers on his hand, but both the players are on with AK. The C4 has gone down. Rotations have been made. Veerbhadra would be going through the smoke, I think so. But the smoke has already gone off and Veerbhadra is trying to make a move, but Venom is still holding his cozy properly. Someone to peek. And Kappa comes from behind, gets Veerbhadra. And SMX takes down Venom so easily. So Marksman has taken a lead with the score 6-5.
Yeah. And if you take a look at the money, Marksman, they're really hard pressed. Utilities. I mean, buying utility is going to be a little difficult for them. They're going to get a couple of upgrades to their pistol.
Yeah, it's
there's
easy.
No armor?
Yeah. There's no armor there.
Okay. So, I mean,
I'm damn sure they're definitely going to
lose this round.
Yeah, I'm damn sure.
I mean, if you peek house like that, you're definitely going to lose this round. I understand what Sloan was doing. This was good for them though. Venom is teaming up, getting Mithil. They're peeking mid as well. Now, you've got to remember that the CZs do have low bullets.
Yeah, but
24 like, bullets, it's not too much to work with.
But they, auto pistols, like, they
yeah,
do
they're
act
strong.
Like, yeah.
They're strong, but you have to be careful with your bullet usage because you don't
have
too
a good recoil.
Yeah. Batman, he's pushing house. Riggs has an AK as well. It's going to be rather crucial for Riggs to trade at the very least than Kappa.
Kappa.
That's your own teammate, man.
He just freaked out, like, hey, yeah. Who's there?
Like,
it's me, bro.
Batman gets a risk, Riggs, so that's the AK taken away from Marksman, and now they just left with pistols. They're not even working as a unit. Venom's been brought down, he's spawned in the pit, and it's Pawn who shall fall. Veerbhadra, the lone survivor. Managing to sneak a gun would be nice, but I'm not sure how he does that.
Library's already been smoking, and he is gonna go down by SMX. He just needs to take a little bit, going for the AK, and he goes down.
SMX, beautifully done. Camping the AK there, knowing that someone might come to pick it up. Good stuff coming out from SMX.
That AK was a bait.
Yeah, it was hard bait. Do you play PUBG?
Yeah, I do, bro.
It's like when the drop comes and like there are 10 people camping it and everybody comes running towards the drop and then you pick them off one by one.
What I used to do is like just put a medikit like
a medikit on the floor.
On the floor and like just camp at a door and just like you just have to like punch a hole in the door and just wait for someone to pop in.
Yeah.
And as he comes, like I just start shooting like crazy and he's dead.
I mean, yeah, this works when the circles are smaller.
Yeah.
Or if you land in a crowded place.
Mostly school.
School, yes.
Yeah, school.
Real men go to school. Boys go to Pochenki.
Anyway. Oh, and meanwhile, Pawn picks Mithil. It's a 3v5 situation. Doesn't look good for Akramaks, and the teammates on Akramaks' side are raging. That's teasing going on between both the teams.
I mean, it's the double up setup, right? Riggs got one kill. If I'm not mistaken, he peaked mid and got the early headshot, so they were working with an advantage. And there's a follow-up as well. They're trying to push Banana. There is the smoke that's going to push Veerbhadra back. Veerbhadra does have an AWP. He peeks. He knows that they were flashed. He misses both these shots and he's fallen back into smoke. They are spraying into the smoke and Venom will end up falling. Banana will fall as well. I mean, Veerbhadra will fall as well. Beautiful stuff coming out from Veerbhadra. He's going to be hitting himself on his head. But he peeked during a flash and missed two crucial shots which could have won Marksman the round. Now, it's an attempt to retake from Sloan. Riggs, they're pushing through, they manage to take down Kappa, they're taking down Manan. Riggs, well, he helps bring down Slonin, but can he bring down SMX? No, he can't! Akramaks win the round, and there are ops on the floor for them.
What a comeback, a 3-5 situation, a comeback, man. Like, Manan takes down 2, SMX takes down 3. This is an amazing game. Like, Akramaks have to come up with something because this is not working for them. Well, nice. of coming in on Kappa. Let's see, can he hit the flags? Well, the two CDs are actually rushing. And will Kappa lose a shot? CDs are actually rushing from mid, but Vibhadra would make an exchange. And the players are going down one by one. Exchange of flags have been made. 3-on-3 situation instantly.
It's a 3-on-3. I like the idea of pushing mid. It was a good call, whoever did it. But they didn't get the trades that they were hoping for, and Slowden falls.
Oh, but look at Rix. He is actually just below them. They have no clue.
Rix, like a rat in the gutter. Manan at 38% HP. Kappa low as well. Venom doesn't spin down SMX. Rix from the back. Brings down one. Brings down another. And Marksmen, in what was a hard buy of sorts, make a comeback into the round. Beautiful stuff coming out from them. 6-8 is the score. It's still anyone's game for the taking. But in my opinion, Jareen, Marksmen, they're going to be a little disappointed that they gave away so many rounds of CT. This shouldn't be happening.
But for even for Akramaks, it's going to be a little bit easy because they have like a nice score line for them. It's 8 to, but this can be anyone's round because this is the last round of the first half. This can be anyone's round.
Yeah. Pushing Banana aggressively. Kappa burning in the flames. 12% HP. They flash on the side. But Kappa manages to bring him down without taking a single ounce of damage. He wants to push Banana. He needs backup. It's a 3-on-5. And Slonin, with a shot, if I'm not mistaken, they're waiting patiently in mid. It's crucial that nobody from the side of the marksman forces the issue here. They need to play it cautious. A good way to start this round is Vibhadra getting a pick with the AWP. Kappa low. They're walking Banana. There comes flash number one. Smoke towards CD. Vibhadra flashed. He goes for the shot blind. He falls back to the smoke. Throws a molly on the floor. So that's going to push them back a little bit. Batman at 29 HP. Manan at 12. It's possible for the Akramaks to win. A lot of it depends on Rix. But where is Rix? Anyways, they get the card and Rix has fallen. I take his name and he goes down. It's a 2v5. And Marksman, it's going to be really difficult for
Kappa. Kappa is spamming. The shots do connect on Vibhadra. Vibhadra's on the line. Oh, he's going for a knife on
zoom. On zoom, like Hrithik Roshan in Tamil. And Manan with the knife to the back of Vibhadra.
That's a perfect backstab. That's a perfect backstab to Vibhadra.
You know what? I don't know how you can even type GH after knifing someone in the back. It's a joke. Come on.
It should be JH. Joke half.
Joke half. 6-9 is the score. Akramaks have done well for themselves. And once again, the momentum of the next half is going to be dictated by who wins the pistol round.
Because pistol round is very important. If you get that like early, as you have this. In the first half, we saw that like Marksmen got a lead with the pistol round and they got the next two rounds as well, next four rounds as well. But that was really amazing.
So in the pistol round, in my opinion, I see two ways this pans out. Marksmen at mid should have the advantage with the USP. So I wouldn't like Akramaks rushing mid. A Banana seems to be a safer bet, and this is where I'd like Marksmen to throw some utility once again into Banana. Maybe a smoke, maybe a molly, keep them at bay, delay the push from Banana, and make sure that they don't have the advantage at close range with the Glocks.
But even after the recent update on the CSGO, the range damage of the Glock has been
It's good, but it is good, but it's a little harder to get those shots. I think it's easier with the USP, that's it. Anyway, they are pushing mid, so he's in Banana all by himself. What range if you're not even going to fire a single bullet? Vibhadra all by himself. They're holding Banana. It's a 4v5. There's a lot of Kevlar on the side of the CTs. It's a hard round for the marksmen.
There's no kit on them, so that might be. Because on the marksman side, when they were playing as CT, I saw a kit on Rix. That is actually good because like if you engage late for a retake, you need a kit. Because you just have like 5 seconds with the kit, and without a kit, it goes for 10 seconds. So that's actually even a single second that it matters. Apparently, teams are actually just moving really slowly. Marksmen are going for. Okay, so there is going to be a smoke coming in from Vibhadra. He's going to block off the CT side, and currently they are now going to go push very aggressively on bomb side B. They have already made an entrance, and Venom gets Batman. And now it's a situation of 4v4. The both team lines are equal.
Yeah.
Kappa is just waiting for someone to plant the same position. And Kappa does connect a shot, a random shot on Veer Bhadra from the coffins.
It's like you mentioned, right? Maybe they had a defusal kit, they could play this slow, play this cautious. But they themselves have put them upon a timer. SMX does manage to get Ritz, but Venom and Veer Bhadra bring down SMX, Kappa, and eventually Mithil will fall as well. Marksmen win the round, and once again, the pistol
goes to this Marksmen.
Time, yeah,
again.
I mean, Akramaks won the CT pistol though.
They got the primary, also won the pistol round.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Apologies. Marksmen won the CT pistol, they also won the T pistol, and they also get the plant. So that's a lot of money coming in. It's Diwali Bakshish going the way of Marksmen.
Just won a lottery by planting the bomb, and Kappa has gone for an SMG instead of like a pistol.
That is ballsy.
And well, few upgraded pistols, yeah, two Digs and two CZs and an SMG.
I mean,
will this change things for them?
So if you had an SMG and your opponents had pistols, that's a win-win of sorts. But if you have an SMG and your opponents have SMGs and Galils as well, if you end up giving away that SMG, you're going to be begging your teammates for drops next time around. That's what's going to happen. If Kappa doesn't get too much done this round, it's going to hurt him more. It's going to hurt his team more because he's going to be, "Arey, mujhe drop de yaar. Mujhe gun de yaar. Mujhe op de yaar." And there's always one of those in every stack in CS matchmaking.
I wish you could look also. Oh! Venom comes in. So with there goes a
that
bang.
Okay, that's Manan down. Yeah. Venom, beautiful headshot coming out from him. He looks good in the photos and his headshots look even better.
But still, no rotations have been made from the bowling alley, and SMX comes in and gets Veer Bhadra going for Slowin, but no, Slowin takes him down with the SMG. It's a 4v3 situation, and two CZs and an SMG can make some difference for them. But Mithil is just holding the pose, but Slowin doesn't want to push there. Well, looks like a rotation, wrong time rotations have been made.
Okay, but Batman, he's hanging with back. Okay, they're actually going to stack one on to this bomb site and then move
over. They are confused. Oh my god, they are making a huge mistake. Batman is just confused. Where should I go?
What is going on? It's like the Lok Sabha when they have to pass a bill. Nobody knows what they're doing.
But no, look at the map. Like, the C4 has also rotated, and again the rotation has been made to the alley. Oh my god, that. The C4 is alone on the bomb side. He's just planted there.
Kappa?
No one there.
There's Kappa.
Kappa goes down.
And now I have to ask you, sir, what did he do with that SMG? Honestly, it's bad timing. I mean, everybody's entering side. Marksmen win the round.
They just confused the hell out of them. Like, they didn't knew, the CTs didn't knew what they were doing. It was just random rotations here and there. They were just walking into the park.
Everybody confused everybody there. I was confused, you were confused, they were confused.
I thought it's a rotation and then it wasn't not. And then again the C4 came to alley, and then again he went to B at bit, and again came to alley, and then he went and planted the bomb.
I mean, they faked every bomb site, they even faked another map, and nobody knew what is going on. But this time around, the CTs are poor. Pawn does manage to bring down SMX, good set of nades, and gets two with the spray. Batman and Vanan will fall. Mithil peeking, he has a USP and 24 HP. The nade is there. Two kills with two nades here, and it's Kappa versus the world. Kappa. Not a gun nearby. He's sitting at 100 HP, brings down Pawn with the headshot and manages to secure an SMG. He's pushing aggressively. He has nothing to lose. YOLO is the word. But a nade hits him in the bum and he's at 21 HP.
Well, he has to say, Slowin from behind will get Kappa. Kappa goes down at 99. The score line, the score are equal now. Well, Marksmen coming with a nice comeback in this game. Like, they have like stepped up the game. Well, but now, like, we will see like a proper rifle buy coming in from the Akramaks as well. So
it is a rifle buy, but they're actually a little poor if you look at it. I mean,
they don't have resources.
Yeah,
they do have like 5 smokes, but they just to block poses. But they can't like flash anyone, like just to blind them and get a frag on them, or just to make them push a little more slow after the smoke goes off.
Yeah. And despite having 5 smokes, nobody's attempted to smoke banana just yet. They're leaving banana open, which means...
No, it's actually because they don't want them... When the push is coming, they want to block them at that point of time.
Oh, okay. They're going to wait for them to push close and then throw the smoke.
They want to waste like their more time as they can like keep them off from the bomb site.
Okay. But if you got five smokes, what if you throw a smoke at Banana early on and then you delay a push from 17 seconds? Okay, they're assuming, they already know that marksmen are going to push late and that's why they're holding on to it?
Because it's a rifle-rifle fight, so both the teams know that like
okay,
it's going to be a heavy fight between them. So they want to play a little passive.
Okay.
Venom is going in for frags, he gets down.
Manan does get. So it's a 2v4. Marksmen, you said they played well the last round, but this round it's going to be a hard ask for them to win it.
This AK is just giving me, like, it's confusing me. I thought it was a Kar 98. When it was on the ground, I thought it was a Kar 98.
Too much PUBG.
Yeah, too much PUBG.
PUBG in the world in general.
Yeah. It has taken on everything.
Yeah, I mean, it has twice. It has been back in this game, so people are giving up. Manan brought down, Mithil gets one. It's one on two. But Akramaks, they win the round. It was rather crucial for them to win this. Their money was awful. And now they're working with something at the very least. There are a couple of AKs. One AK, to be precise. So Mithil could even drop it if he wants to. I like this call. I like this call. It's crucial to just look back at the game and rethink how you want to approach it. In your opinion, if you were the IGL right now for the marksman and you were sitting there, what would you tell them to do differently? What's the plan for the marksman?
I would have like actually gone very aggressive gameplay on the banana side because there are only just two guys holding and there's this one common posy. They actually just stacking on the city side, so it would be very easy for us like just to smoke on the city side. But the guy won't have like much vision to engage with us like on T side when we are rushing towards banana, and then one smoke towards the coffin.
Okay.
And behind that construction line, behind construction, there's a
coffin.
So I smoke over there and then I move towards my side and just take with few flashes I engage.
Smoke coffin, smoke CD, flash.
Basically, because it's a very balanced map.
Because there's just two guys holding and it gives me like more time to have like get my own posies until the rotation comes. I'll go on like a nice passive posy just to hold where the players can come in, and I'll just make sure once they're still holding the banana, so if any rotations are going to be from the CD.
Right. So a couple of guys push, a couple of smokes, one at coffin, one and one holds CT, check the CT stack, one guy holds banana, and then you secure the bomb site and make sure that you don't peek and give away a hasty retake to the CT.
But after playing something I haven't seen on like pro teams.
In the sixth round,
like they do, but
alone killed five
not,
guys.
Not that
and managed
much.
To change the momentum,
comparatively
bring it
like
back in the favor of Akramaks, and then they went on to win what 9 rounds in the half. So they are in the lead
the
right now. I am really excited to see what happens.
Three guys on. Okay.
They have to be three guys, one at the house, one in pits,
yeah.
And one
isn't
should take care of the arch and the library, so they can't like push from the city side towards the
from mid to
mid to left.
He said he
mid to left.
If even a single team just makes an entry from like the city arch, it can be a disaster, because if no one is looking, he can get the alley clear for his teammates.
He ended up killing one versus four in the end.
Riggs.
Mithil is just going for the rotation at bombsite. There is no one. They're just smoking off. If you see on bombsite A, they're just smoking on bombsite B. They're just smoking on bombsite B over there.
Okay.
And currently.
But SMX in a good position in the pit. Gets looking at balcony. Riggs peaks with the op. Riggs fails with the op. And it's a man advantage towards the Akramaks. The timeout didn't do them much good. Good luck on the side. Good ball to Mithil. Spawn was the wall. Get stupid! SMX brings him down. And the Akramaks take what could be a crucial round in the second half. Beautiful stuff coming out. That's play by Pawn though. Pretty good, but not enough.
Mithil is going to go for an overtime.
Are we seeing overtime?
Face off right now.
Yeah, I think it's going to go for an overtime, but because Venom is not going to let them win. That easy.
I mean, Venom doing pretty decent, sitting atop the score chart. And lots at stake. These two teams
in
the top of the
table.
A win in CS,
I believe
and possibly a win in CS. Set them up for
the MVP.
MVP?
Yeah.
It's very difficult to be alive in this competition. Everyone has performed so well.
And the second half is going to be very important. Let's go back into the game and find out.
Because I've seen like players is rushing. Just YOLO rush and then that.
Man in. Slowly pushing the B bombs.
I think
it's a fake.
I would give the MVP to Mithil because that 1v5 clutch.
Yeah, it's between Mithil and Manan for me.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
They both did great. He was on low HP, Manan, and he pulled out a round.
Yeah, I mean, definitely Mithil did make the passive. But what I'm a little disappointed about is that other than Veerbhadra, nobody has had any impact with the AWP. Rick's last round did end up buying an AWP, just gave it away.
We have actually AWP on the city side, like that's Kappa, but he is like now sticking towards the rifle.
Yeah.
And he's also the in-game leader for the team. So
Anand gets one.
He's not picking unnecessary, he's just going over there and
peaks.
Oh, but Venom goes.
But the trade, Mithil and Manan, they're both the MVPs. And look at this, Batman on top of the box, gets one, wants to get the second, but risk with the SMG, manages to bring him down. He pushes through the Molly, he wants to push through the smoke. This is the literal definition of the word YOLO.
Well, he's gonna save because he doesn't have much time. The C4 is not with him and he is just saving his. And he has armor, but he goes down. But did he go down after the time? Because if it was a save, he doesn't get any money. One second.
He's sitting at $600. $600. My bad.
That perfect timing on zero. It comes on zero, he gets a save, and then he dies. Oh, this guy. He can just buy a smoke and a grenade. That's.
I mean, now the play from Marksmen is going to make it obvious, right? They have to wait patiently, they've not got any Kevlar, there's one flash on Venom, it's been thrown out already. I mean, this time around the Marksmen are pretty much just hoping that the Akramaks make a mistake and goof up. That's what it's going to take them to win the round. When it takes one, that is a small but crucial error, but Batman gets the trade. Batman down to 48 health.
At least give
Pawn gets a gun. Pawn is a bomb, he's just pushing in. He walks through the smoke. Kappa with the flash. Kappa did end up seeing Pawn atop the box, flashes for a second. But Batman brings down both of them. And Kappa, he's waiting for more. It's Slonin and Risk. Rix, he's looping around CT spawn.
That's what I said last for my stat. What I was gonna do
was this.
I said I was gonna smoke the coffin side, and that was the mistake that they did. They didn't smoke up the coffin.
Right.
So Batman got two kills easily from there because he had like a straight fire for it.
Yeah, you gotta smoke out coffin and ensure that the Akramaks don't set up good crossfires like that. I mean, but yeah, the Marksmen, they got a little bit of money. Akramaks
they got utility to work with.
They've got decent utility, they've got Kevlar, they've got helmets. And in Bombay, if you're not wearing helmets, you know what the police will do to you.
It's easy to go out, but I won't say that word.
Huh?
I don't want to say that, but it's easy to go out.
Venom's been brought down to 50 health. I presume it was a spray at Banana. Venom does like to hang around Banana a fair bit. And
Jason is going to go in YOLO.
Okay. So Venom and Rix trading guns. Venom realizing that he's at lower health gives the AK to Rix. Rix hoping to find an entry into the B bomb site. Once again, there are no smokes. The flash comes flying through from Venom. Rix doesn't think he's yet. Venom and Rix walking through Banana. The nade narrowly missing Venom.
That nade just tickled them. That wasn't a huge damage.
It didn't connect on Venom at all. I mean, Venom's still at 51 health.
They're still not smoking, coughing, and Batman is just holding them.
He was caught looking at his gun. He was looking at his gun, and now he's going to be brought down for that.
Oh my god, a 3v5 situation now. The C4 is already on the outside. But the CTs are. Okay, so now they are going for the safe. They don't want to risk their gun.
Yeah, I mean, that was silly. Batman was just inspecting his AK. And.
Oh, he just by mistake pressed F to just inspect his weapon.
Yeah, that shouldn't be happening.
These are actually just gonna go for the hunt. But looking at their cash, they should not. The same mistake would again repeat. Like last time, Veerbhadra punished them for like pushing.
Yeah, but one thing is that the Akramaks are a little bit more disciplined. They're not playing their saves like. I mean, they're being a little careful. They do save an SMG, and it's Biosauce. Kappa has the op. I think this is the first time we're going to see Kappa hopping.
On the city side, yes.
On the city side, yeah.
There's no op on the city side, though.
Yeah. If Kappa gets the peak, he's moved towards mid. I'm not sure what his spawn was like. He wants the peak. The flash, though, came out. And Kappa, one man to get that pick off that he was looking for. He's going for round two. Slonin, blinded. Slonin peaks. Spawn.
He just falls back, like, immediately.
Yeah.
But he is actually going for Kappa only. His gameplay is like with Manan is waiting for the Kappa way. Extremely passive on both the teams. No one is moving. What's happening between the teams? The teasing is going on, the rage.
I mean, they're having fun, right? They're passionate about the game and it shows. Venom. Venom. Stacked. Looking for Batman.
But Venom gets clipped by the. Oh, but that's Kappa. A leg shot. I think Kappa will make a change for this side, but C4 is still holding at the.
And Ricks pushes through the smoke. Kappa gets Venom. Batman gets Ricks. Akramaks, it's 5v3. Spawn has the bomb.
But then Kappa goes down with a headshot by Slowen and Batman goes by left on the bomb side. He puts down Slowen and goes down by Pawn, but the instant trade has been made by Mithil. Only 1v2, 1-on-2 situation has been made by Pawn over here. The C4 goes down and it's everything on him. He is the solo guy just left. He is actually just holding at the coffin. Will this coffin be for him? Like, will he be buried inside it?
I think so.
Getting back from both the sides, but Manan comes in from behind and puts him in the coffin.
Beautiful stuff coming on from Manan. Looped around. Good retake. Akramaks win the round. 14-10. The marksman.
They just need two rounds. Akramaks just need two rounds to take these sweet 5 points.
Yeah.
In the pocket. Because on the earlier game, like the two games, Marksmen has already won it. Uh-huh. Tekken and Real Cricket, so they were actually on 10 points. So now they have total of 16 points on Marksmen side. And earlier, Akramaks was on the lead before this game. They were on the lead with 11 points. But now have already taken a lead. If they win the CT side, if they win the map,
it
would be 16-16. And the Dota game.
The Dota game is going to be the decider. And I'm taking a look at the lineups in terms of Dota. It's going to be a close game. I mean, both teams have good players. Yeah. I presume you're going to be up for a really close game in terms of Dota as well. Akramaks though, can they close this round to see?
I just think he sees the fort, but.
So Ricks has gone for an op. Veerbhadra has taken damage somewhere across the map. Venom, I mean, he's preferred pushing Banana. This time around, he's pushing mid. Beats left, there was a flash. They know that they've fallen back.
He comes in to roast them, but yeah. Like, if I was there, I would have like gone over the sniper just waiting. And Kappa misses the shot on Venom.
Okay, now he has to fall back and now he has to peek through library. I'm curious if anybody on the T side is actually watching that side. SMX wants to bring down Venom, but Venom with the faster fingers brings down SMX, brings down Manan. And Marksman.
They would save again, like the CTs would save. Look at the CTs are not getting from bomb site. Venom, nice entry from him. It's a 5v2 situation. Nice decision made not to go anywhere.
Batman loves looking at his AK. It's his favorite pastime. We catch him doing that a fair bit, but yeah, I don't blame him. Now we have to save. It'd be silly if the marksman peek and give away a couple of kills, like how Veerbhadra got a couple of exit frags last time around when he was on the CD side. Akramaks, they hope to stay alive. One, they want to hunt their pawn. Goes through. Mithilf got him for sure, but there are two more members pushing. Mithilf waiting, brings down Veerbhadra. While Rix and Veerpatra team up, bring down Mithil. Batman managed to bring down Sloan in. It's Rix with the AWP. He doesn't want to give it away.
This is weird.
Yeah, I think Batman's never seen a gun. The money.
Batman like should have gone for a risk over there and should have taken the AWP from Rix.
You think he should have tried?
Yeah, he should have tried because. And the team is encouraging the players and also raising on the opponents.
Rix still has the AWP, hasn't done too much with it just yet. Man and Kappa on a bunch of pistols.
Perfect timing with the smoke blocking them off.
It's a good smoke blocking them off, but I think the Marksmen know that the Akramaks are running an eco of sorts.
But Kappa with the Deagle, that investment is... because he doesn't have any armor.
Yeah, it's a risk. The first shot will miss. They're pushing him through. Venom gets the kill. Kappa had the Deagle, didn't have the armor and got punished for it. They're pushing mid and slowly but surely, this should be a round that the Marksmen should win.
Again, the same strategy is being used, Venom in the gun game. And Manan picks down Venom. He goes down instantly by Slowin.
It's a 4v3
situation. Slowin. Should I count him or no? I don't know. But Mithil is with an AK. He gets Slowin as well with that spam. It's a 2v2 situation. Rix with still an, with an AWP.
Rix with an AWP. Pawn with an AK. Rix picks up the bomb. 2v2. It's Batman and Mithil.
C4 is onside. C4 goes down. Rix has just planted the bomb. But Pawn is it's on a very safe position right now.
It's a good thing they have the smoke. It's going to buy them some time and pretty much force Akramaks from enter to mid from for entry from mid to right. Excuse me. Batman going in. The flash.
That's the fashion for Mithil. And Mithil picked up Pawn. That's a nice shot coming in from Mithil. The Rix alone guy left with an AWP, but he's not going to play with the CZ because it's auto. And it's a 1v1 situation. He misses Anjuma Mithil and Mithil picks him up. And 10 seconds for C4. Will it blow? I think so. It's not going to happen for Mithil. And the C4 goes off and Marksman wins this. That's the importance of a defuse kit.
Yeah, well said, Janine. I couldn't agree more. The Akramaks were hard-pressed for money, but even then, in such scenarios, it's essential for someone from the side of Akramaks to buy the piece of kit. It's like buying a condom. You forget, and it hurts you in the bum.
That's true. But were they on an eco, right?
They were on an eco of sorts. I don't blame them.
Yeah. It was a good retake. They still managed to get down all the five players.
But even if you're on the eco, you've got to prioritize certain things. And look at it, Mithil, he's learned from his mistakes. That could have been a win for Akramaks, but they're not having a win. Mithil, Kappa, they're dying like flies, and it's an easy win for Marksmen. And Jareen, I think you're right. The possibility of overtime is upon us.
Yes. I thought.
I'm sorry, for those of you watching this on YouTube, we can't help but resist because, I mean, if you are here, and I'm sure you're going to see it, the dugout is the place to be. Both teams having a good jive at each other. Half these are people I don't understand because I don't know what. I think this is worth a video in itself. But yeah, 13-14 is the score.
Marksman asked. No. Akramaks to wear us out.
Strategy in the dugout. They're all planning what their response should be if they lose this round. Dugout strategy here. Anyway,
the 2-minute timer actually is like the planning stage for the dugout guys to like just plan what to say, and the 15-second freeze time for the teammates for the team is for them to shout at them.
Exactly. There are two games that are going on here. There's one in the dugout, there's one in the main stage. But what matters is the main stage. And right now, 14-13 is the score. Akramaks, they have managed to buy. Kappa does have a defusal kit. It's a healthy buy coming out from both sides. And it's not going to be a good start for Marksman if Manan managed to bring down Slowin. Venom gets a pick on SMX. It's a 4v4, but Venom, he's at 23 HP.
He's really low on HP, but the smoke can work for him. Like, he, before dying, he should at least like place it somewhere proper for his team to enter.
Yeah.
But Veerbhadra is really good with all resources and AK and the armor. He is properly equipped with everything. Mm-hmm. I'm actually dependent on him.
The spray will whip and Kappa peeks again and brings him down. Beautiful stuff coming up from the Akramaks here. 4v3, Venom at 23 health. How do the monster do this?
They push
through
clear.
Banana. Batman hanging in the smoke. Venom is down Banana. It's Batman and Mithil versus Rix and Veerbhadra. And Venom, who's at 1 HP.
1 HP, man. He's really low on HP. He's just 1 HP. He is just gonna save. He is not gonna risk this round.
But
he is playing really, really far from the total game.
Batman.
Even if they
offense. Veerbhadra, Rix is brought down. Venom at 1 HP, Veerbhadra on 79.
But Venom is coming like a superhero. What a backstab. He is low on HP, but oh that crossfire from Mithil. He won't enter the bomb idea. Okay, he is going for a save. And he will go for a save. It's 14 to 14. Oh my
god. It's
not
even a point that separates them at this stage. The money, not looking too good for the Akramaks. Do you think pushing house might be a strategy that could be rewarded here for the Akramaks?
Okay, and Marksmen have taken a timeout. I thought like it would come from Akramaks side, but okay.
It's just a casual break. Venom guiding his team. Like the captain
don't
that he
worry.
Is.
Everything is fine. यहाँ पे ब्लॉक कर हाँ ऐसे जाऊँगा
रात को डिनर के लिए दाल मखनी
and on the other side okay I do think they are just ये उधर जाएगा उधर ऐसे वो था pointing at something like towards upside नहीं उधर जाएगा उधर अच्छा he was asking for a stack let's see might be asking for a stack or like
and
a push.
Yeah, rightly so, he has a pistol, so a stack is needed for SMX.
Yeah. Okay, he might play from the city right, like mid right. There's a
mid right stack? Oh, that's stack, yeah.
Stack. He might play from that position.
Rix is the op. I mean, Rix is an old friend of mine, but he hasn't really impact that an opper can have. He's had a hard time as an opper. Hasn't gotten too much done with the AWP. I'd actually like to see him buy an AK because, in the previous round, Rix had the AWP and it was a clutch. It was a 1v2. And he actually decided to use his pistol over the AWP. That's how certain he is of his own AWPing skills. And if you're not sure of yourself as an AWPer, you shouldn't be AWPing.
CDs are playing with really fast. They don't even want to show, like, they are just actually holding on the bomb side.
Where is SMX? Has he gotten that stack? Can we take a look?
He's actually waiting.
Okay, he didn't get the mid to right stack.
I thought he would because he was doing something. Hey, udhar jayega kya?
Yeah.
Like no. Man is like no.
I it could also be that
you're
SMX.
Heavy.
I mean, Manan's heavy, but
yeah. Still, coming back to the game.
Yeah, 14-14. Yeah.
The thieves are actually just holding.
Okay, so
they haven't made any sound, but yeah, SMX is just rotating from the CT side.
Mm-hmm. So they you said smoke coffins, CT.
Yes.
And push through. Now they have one smoke on Venom and they have one on Rix. The smoke dissipates.
Poses.
Venom peeking slowly. Gets 9 HP on Venom and brings him down. The molly comes through, but SMX, they couldn't stack it, but he's done more than enough with the pistol. Kappa brings up Rix, and somehow with the crossfire, Akramaks wins the round. 15-14 is the score. And if you take a look at the money, well, Veerbhadra has some of it. He's going to have to drop left, right, and center, and he's doing just that.
Well, this is the
that,
last
that was
round.
A near eco coming up from Akramaks, and they won it. Beautiful stuff coming up in there.
thrown at the teammates. Like, we can see one gunner and SMG and three rifles, AKs, and two farmers. So it's kind of an equal game for both the teams. But coming to the resources part, like,
it's like they heard you. They've all bought defusal kits. They'll all sit together and defuse them.
No, because this is the last round. They don't have anything to do. Like,
they have nothing to lose. I agree.
Like in the last game, like I gave an example. It's like your parents just give you like 100 rupees. Jo fataka aata jaake leke aa. So hume jo itna milega leke aa. So it's like the last money you have. Like you have to spend everything on this thing.
Yeah.
Ek kit bhi le lete.
Yeah, why not? I agree.
So it's like that, but okay. They are actually making an entry.
Pushing banana. Marksmen could be brought down. Marksmen falls at 12.
5v3. And the city is going down. Looks like we are going for an overtime here. Ladies and gentlemen, this game is also going to go for an overtime. It's 15 to 14, but looks like the marksmen are going to take this one. It's a 2v4 situation.
Wait for the wraparound.
He goes down.
It's SMX versus the world, and what can he do? He's pushing through smoke, he's falling back. SMX is no round to save for. You might as well try something. Anyway, waits for the smoke to dissipate. Pawn atop the box, waiting for him. Ricks will fall. He's waiting for people from behind, but two of
shots,
them.
And it goes for an OT. 15 to 15, the scoreline. The game has gone for an overtime.
Tell me a little bit about overtime. How do you want to play overtime? In your opinion?
We already have like 10k cash.
Right.
So I would actually still play like little conjure types. Because I won't like go for an op or something like that. Because I don't want to like really spend on my first round. I'll still go for a rifle. That's perfect for me. And I'll play a little passive because if I lose the first round, I would then go for an AWP because at the third, even I get like a little bit bonus after when I die. So
okay. Like for those of us who don't watch Counter-Strike or are new to the game, how does overtime work? So it's a best of six?
Yeah.
And what's the win condition?
So whoever wins like the four rounds in a row or like anyhow, like you just need to
So the first to hit four rounds?
Yeah.
Okay. And then if you tie at 3-3, then you go into the next overtime.
Next overtime.
And then life doesn't end and then you cut yourself. But yeah, four rounds is the win condition.
And
the
volley
will win. We come from a country of great fast bowlers, but slow and can't throw a molly for God's sake.
Oh, that was really slow and didn't win.
Yeah. Didn't go in the window. Rix, has he gone for the AWP? No, they've actually switched things up. Veerbhadra's AWPing this time around. And I've seen Veerbhadra in the past. He's a pretty decent AWPer.
Kappa,
the better of the two, manages to bring down Veerbhadra.
Kappa wins the scope war over here at mid. Very aggressive now. They pick down slow and he goes in. It was like a 3-0 made. And one by one, the players are going down. Pawn picks down Manan. Situation, Kappa still with the AWP. And SMX goes down. 3v2, Kappa's low on HP. Batman, everything has to be pulled off from him because he is the cyber. But they have got a call to save. Let's save our asses. Perfect save coming in from the CTs because I don't think so they would actually go and risk their AWP.
Yeah, I mean, Kappa got off a good start by bringing down Veerbhadra. But
Kappa picks up Pawn and goes down by Rick. Nice shot there. And Mr. Short, will he go with the aggressive one? But no, the timer would save him.
Wow, they're investing heavily in the
AWP.
Let's take it
here. This is the game. But even if they lose like Kappa, what? What if Kappa has so much cash after getting like two options?
to whatever drop from his teammates, but Riggs, the beast, picks down two. It's a 4v3 situation. Kappa still with the AWP. Let's see. Kappa. He is holding there, but the players have already fallen back and they are actually planning. They're just actually like holding mid, just a peekaboo game by Pawn.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and why not? They have the man advantage. They're looking if the Akramaks are about to slip up. They're going to play this patiently, cautiously, and with a good amount of descendant marksmen. They sense that victory is a possibility. And Kappa still has the AWP. That's what you got to really watch out for. Kappa. Which bomb side is Kappa at?
Well, Kappa is actually holding from the CT side.
He's watching B from CT side.
Yeah, but there is a smoke gunner which is going to come soon.
Yeah, he needs to be careful. He could
Riggs is actually going to smoke off Coffin this time. And yes, that's perfect. He doesn't want to risk.
They're pushing. Manan has to fall back. Flashed as well. They're pushing the bomb side with Coffin. Likely that Akramaks can make an entry. Manan will fall. It's a 2v4. They manage to isolate Kappa. There's nowhere he is. And Kappa, really, it's a hard ask for him. But he's going to try anyways. The B bomb side. Kappa gets Veerbhadra. The patience rewarded. He's looking for more. He is flashed. And Sloan brings him down. It's Mythil.
Already going for a save before even like engaging any fight.
So that was a little unusual. I mean,
but
if Kappa wanted to attempt a retake, I'm not sure why he did it without Mythil.
You were actually like, was trying to run there, but to save on the right side, but there was a huge fire coming towards him, so he couldn't do much.
So, Kappa
But actually, Mythil had gone with him like just for a backup, like just to cover, just for a cover fire.
Okay.
So, you can see Mythil would have
been
able to cover fire
for
the same side.
Should be even provide cover fire. Anyways, a little communication, a little lack of communication coming up from the Akramaks, and the marksman two rounds away from victory.
Look at Mythil's stats. He has got a 3 kill and a 5 kill in the CT side, on the T side, and now has also had a 4 flag. Quad kill coming in between the rounds. Mythil is just playing like a monster. Again, so, the same strategy is being made, like the T's are actually holding. They're just keeping the C4 at a safe position. They'll just go look for the plosives, where the CTs are holding, what's going on. They want to get the hold of the situation and then they'll and go for the plant where the site is clear. So that's the main plant.
Yeah, I mean, B seems to be their priority. Smoke, but when they're blinded, there's not much you can do. It's a trade though, because Pawn manages to come back in and find Batman.
But still, the teams stay equal, a 4v4 situation, instant exchange of frag has been made. But they're still like, just faking on bomb side B now. And the rotation that we made, that they are successful in making that fake play on the bomb side B because of the rotation. If you can see,
actually, he's rotating back to A. They're going to be 3 at A.
Nice sound sense coming in from the guy who is actually holding.
Going down to SMX, SMX gets to make that three. He's gone half with the famine and he breaks by himself. The Akramaks strike back. SMX, you beast.
Oh my god,
Jesus.
This guy went for a spree. I haven't seen B90.
A B90?
B90. Spray and play.
Yeah, Akramaks win the round. The first half of overtime goes 17-16. Two rounds for the marksman.
They need two more rounds to win, and Akramaks has shown all these three rounds. If Akramaks wins all three rounds, now it's a switch on the B side.
You think the marksman has this?
I
think so. Two, you know. I mean, I'd like to see Veerbhadra AWP actually. He's a pretty decent AWPer. I've seen him AWP in professional games a fair bit. Not all the time, but he does it every now and then. And he's pretty decent with the AWP. I think there is scope to op on the city side, especially around Banana and Mid as well. If Veerbhadra, yeah, Veerbhadra's picked up the op. I've seen him do this, so no surprises that they haven't let Rix pick up the op. So whoever made that call, I really respect that. Kappa has an op as well. Kappa has pretty much been getting these crucial pickoffs that gave his team the man advantage. Let's see if he can do it again. Marksmen two rounds away from winning the half and winning the game.
Oh, that's a peekaboo at mid. But it's not aggressive play. Like, I want to see like aggressive gameplay more because
from the terrace?
Yeah, from the tees because.
Okay.
Oh, a stack coming in for pawn. Okay, so it was the first pawn actually.
Pawn gets a stack. He's getting a lot of information out of this. He knows that the terrace are hanging around defensively. Ultimate. Just gonna pump in a few bullets through the smoke.
He should have given his cozy there. He should have like waited properly because they won't expect
he's
him.
Speaking,
to come
he's given away.
Yeah,
now he has to fall back. So if Akramaks want to, they could try and push through Banana. Another stack for pawn. This guy is not afraid of heights, and Venom just keeps putting him up there.
Meanwhile, the C4 is at when the players are actually trying to make an end to the bomb game, which is gonna work for them.
There's a molly on the right, a smoke on the left. I mean, it's clear that they're at mid. They're pushing through house as well. A flash comes in, they need to check pit. I'm not sure what's going on. Kappa with the op, Veerbhadra brings down Manan. It's a man at one. Veerbhadra brings down two. The man, the aim, the machine, the myth, the legend, it continues. He brings down Batman and Venom with the kill onto Mithil. Marksmen, they're one round away from victory. And they can taste it in the air.
Veerbhadra making those change, man.
Like, I mean, I said it at the beginning of this round. I've seen this guy play a lot and he likes to op. He's actually a decent opper. And I'd like to see Marksmen just switch it up, make Veerbhadra the primary opper. And maybe risk only Rix when you only really need it. Anyway, once again, Banana game. Batman managed to pick up one. Venom takes
they
out
are playing
Manon
very
Venom.
Aggressive. They need this. They are just hungry for the frags. They're just killing because they are just hungry for the frags. They are just and they just fall back, giving them a huge damage for this situation.
Yeah, that's good. They push Banana. They managed to bring down two, and they're working with a man advantage. They're working with a wave of confidence.
Because this would be just the last round for the Marksmen. They bring this to the end.
Yeah. Mithil. Pushing mid. SMX wants to eat a little bit as well. The op still with Veerbhadra. Veerbhadra was an absolute beast the last time around on the A bomb side. Can he do it again?
Will they just like stack pawn everywhere? Like?
Oh, Veerbhadra brings down Kappa. SMX Manchester. Marksmen win the round and look at them go.
19-16, they win this. It's gonna be sweet, easy 5 points for them.